Access options for Visual Studio subscriptions. There are two main options your subscribers have for accessing their Visual Studio subscriptions. This video will explain Microsoft accounts and work or school accounts, which are a feature of managed tenants like Microsoft 365 or Azure Active Directory. We'll also show the impacts of choosing a type of account for your subscribers and some of the benefits that come with managed tenants, such as improved security and ease of subscription management. What is a Microsoft account, or MSA? The Microsoft account, commonly referred to as an MSA, is a personal email account owned by an individual to access Microsoft services when an organization isn't using a managed tenant for M365 or Azure AD. An MSA is set up by the individual and maintained by the individual. For example, Kai may have set up kai.carter20@outlook.com as his MSA. This would be created, owned, and maintained by him. Why would subscribers need an MSA? Companies use MSAs when they're not using managed services by Microsoft, such as M365 or Azure AD, or if they're using managed services from other companies. For example, Kai Carter was assigned a subscription by his company, Contoso. His admin assigned it to his company email, kai@contoso.com. However, Kai needs to make it an MSA because Contoso is not yet using Azure AD or M365. kai@contoso.com is owned and managed on-premise by Contoso, so an MSA needs to be created for Kai to access his subscription. Are there governance risks to using an MSA? Since MSAs are owned by an individual, any policies you've defined for account security, like password strength, won't apply to that MSA. Additionally, if the individual is no longer with the company, they can still access services that are connected to their identity. For example, if Wesley Brooks used his own MSA, wesley.brooks01@outlook.com, to assign Visual Studio subscriptions and manage admins, he would still be able to do this even after he leaves the company if his account is not removed from the Visual Studio subscriptions admin portal. Wesley owns this email address and will continue to own it even after he leaves. This can pose a security risk to your company if the user maintains unauthorized access to confidential information. What can I do about it? Consider transitioning your users to a managed tenant, such as Azure AD or M365, as well as making sure that your subscribers choose a work or school account when signing into their subscription for the first time. What is a managed tenant? A managed tenant is a cloud-based directory that allows the organization to have end-to-end control over the user's access to Microsoft services. This can be achieved in a couple ways through hybrid or full cloud solutions, such as M365 or Azure AD. The organization has full control of the email address and can manage access this way. Why does this matter? Unlike MSAs, managed tenants allow your company to have increased governance and full control over a user's access. For example, let's say that Wesley Brooks is an admin and uses wesley@fabricam.com to manage Visual Studio subscriptions and admins. When Wesley leaves Fabricam, as soon as his email address is deactivated, he no longer has access to sensitive or confidential information like product keys, Azure resources, and more. Wesley also doesn't have the task of setting up and maintaining his own email account, as he would with an MSA. Since the sign-in and security for Wesley's email address is within M365 and entirely in the control of his company, once his account is deactivated, he loses access to cloud services. Is it possible for subscribers to use an M365 or Azure AD work email for their MSA? Yes. Your subscribers can create an MSA out of their work email. For example, Hannah could have an email address assigned to her by her company, such as hannah@fabricam.com. When she's setting it up, Hannah should choose the option to sign in with a work or school account if her organization is using a managed tenant like M365 or Azure AD. If she chooses a personal account, then she will be creating an MSA. This means that even if Hannah left Fabricam and she'd used that email address as an MSA to sign in to other services, such as Visual Studio subscriptions, that would still be her user sign-in. How do managed tenants make Visual Studio subscription management easier? Using an M365 or Azure AD work email as an MSA still provides some ease of administration benefits at the cost of security risk. The Visual Studio Subscriptions Admin Portal will recognize all of your users and be able to track the status of their email accounts. This is helpful because the system will identify when a person's account is deactivated in Azure AD and remove access to the subscription. However, the subscription will still be listed in the portal until it is removed by the admin. If you delete the user out of Azure AD instead of just deactivating them, then the Visual Studio subscription will be automatically removed within 30 days. This makes subscription management easier, since there are fewer steps that an admin needs to take to remove unauthorized access. If you're already on a managed tenant, make sure your users are not using consumer domains like Hotmail or Outlook by looking at their sign-in email address and changing them to their work accounts. For information about how to do this, watch our video at aka.ms/MSA sign-in. Still have questions about how this works? Check out Manage Tenants on M365 or Azure AD at aka.ms/M365 domain and aka.ms/AAD domain.